a sense of sincerity means that you were here to share your story, and that's how I felt. I felt connected to you, even though it's my first time. This is the time that I felt you start out and you felt a little bit like, oh my God, I got lost track. But you dive in. You said, forget it. I'm not going to talk about it. I'm talking about something else. And you took control of that. Good impromptu speech, even though you're an icebreaker. You're able to control your nervousness or your lost track, I guess. Good demeanor means that you have a good stage present. Even though you were here, we'd like for you to move a little bit. Maybe look at each individual, one table. Ruby, look at Sean, and look at myself. So it's kind of like have a little interaction with each individual, one table, second table, and the third table. It helps to kind of relax your nervousness and to help you to add more excitement there. And eye contact was good. I felt that you were looking at me. I felt that connection, so that was good. So you can might look at the other people behind this table there. Good vocal variety. I love that. It's very pleasant. I feel like I can understand you. Good English. Command usage. I felt that I can understand you easily. I know that a lot of us here English are second language, but I felt I can understand you easily. Very sincere, and you give us very easy transition. Start out with boarding school, how that affected you. Came from a very strict family. You were maybe the only child, and that your father sent you to the boarding school, and you have a 9-year-old son. He's a person that kind of affected you, kind of give you some perspective about life. And you gave us three things that I've learned. Be confident, always stand up for yourself, be right, respect yourself, and work hard to achieve things in life. That's three things I learned about you. To help you make this easier, I know you're an icebreaker. You were a little bit struggling at first, but always three aspects. You can use notes or PowerPoint that can help you, maybe starting from your introduction, where you came from, we'd like to hear that. Everybody come from a different place, so we'd like to hear that. Your hobbies, besides Toastmaster, what was your hobby? And also, what was your goal? What do you hope to gain out in Toastmaster? That way you don't have to feel like, oh my God, I have to struggle with one particular aspect of my speech. And also, I felt your pacing at one point is kind of like, you didn't show at what to step, maybe just like I say, step one point, just kind of relax, look at each individual, and then just make eye contact with them. And also, the hand cluster, I feel like maybe you were nervous, you were concerned, oh my God, what am I going to say? I ran out, but just relax, put it out here. If you made a mistake, keep on going. No need to apologize, because that's going to make you more nervous. Preparation, again, like I say, start from make it really simple. Use the KISS techniques. Keep it simple. Make it easier. Introduction, a body, about yourself, and conclusion, what are the things that brought me to join Toastmaster, and how you hope to gain out of it. So, thank you for sharing that with us, and good luck to your next speech.